the group. And I am the hospital administrator at Care Hospital Surat. So we will discuss on what are the importance of the ICT in healthcare. Healthcare information and communication technology. In the use of information technology to improve the process of healthcare delivery and is concerned primarily in streamlining administration and putting information into the hands of point of care professionals, because it's a teamwork which enhances the quality, which will be helping to deliver the best care to the end users. Its use is wide now and plays an important role in the delivery of better and efficient healthcare services. ICT in healthcare is able to increase quality and safety of patient care. It is a part of healthcare structure in any organizations to support the processes and consequently to deliver better outcome to organization and particularly to the patient. Information technology has the potential to improve. One is quality. When you say about the patient care, quality matters much, much better. Safety of documents and files. How you make the documentations. And third comes efficiency. So IT applications fall into several categories. One, administrative and financial systems. That is billing, accounting and other administrative tasks. Second, in clinical systems that facilitate or provide input into the care process, like automated medical record system, we call AMRS, like the one in the hospitals. And third is infrastructure that supports both the administrative and clinical applications, administrative billing and financial general ledger, cost accounting systems, patient registration, personal and payroll, electronic materials management, clinical management, computerized provider, order entry for drugs, lab test procedure, picture archiving and communication systems for filmless imaging, results reporting of laboratory and other tests, clinical decision which supports the system. Apart from that, ICT provides opportunities for individuals, medical professionals and healthcare providers to obtain information, communicate with professionals, deliver first-line support, especially where the distance is a critical factor, and promote preventive medicine programs. Its application in health includes more effective planning, decision-making process and monitoring, improved shared service operations, greater access to more reliable health and population data, and more effective resource management. Today it is very easy to have in healthcare services. We thank NABH because they almost make all these facilities available when they go for the inspection and make the hospitals to get this accreditation. So National Accreditation Board for Hospitals, NABH, is a constituent board of Quality Council of India, QCI, have come up with standards for accrediting hospitals with an aim to provide a framework for quality assurance and quality improvement. The intent of the standards is to provide information to patients about the level of healthcare an institution can or cannot provide. Enhancing easy access to quality in healthcare services, NABH standard definition covers 10 criteria groups. First 5 are patient-centric and the next 5 are organization-centric. Relevant ICT technologies, functionalities, facilitating compliances to these standards are mentioned below, grouped as per NABH criteria. In South and Gujarat, Care Hospital is the only NABH accredited hospital. NABH standards first five, which is of patient-centric, is assessment and continuity of care criteria group. Second, patient rights and education. Third, care of patients. Fourth, management of medication. Fifth, hospital information control. And next is organization-centric. Sixth, continuous quality improvement, responsibilities of management, facilities management and safety, which they consider the fire safety as one of the prime point to be passed. Human resource management, information management system. So when you put it into a nutshell, ICT in medicines, it's related to patient records, medical equipment, expert systems, web-based diagnosis, research and communications. So how it helps in research? ICT has changed the way in which medical research is conducted. Modeling the effects of new drugs, ICT is used to conduct clinical trials, collaboration between international teams. Example, Human Genome Project. Web-based diagnosis, that is internet services. You can find a wide variety of medical information such as symptom diagnosis for people who wish to identify their problem without consulting a GP. GP means general practitioner. Access to medical research and journals. Information about side effects. Information about available treatments. Expert systems, also called knowledge-based systems. They are computer programs that attempt to replicate the performance of a human expert on some specialized reasoning task, store and manipulate knowledge so that they can help the user to solve a problem or make a decision. Expert systems are being used for disease diagnosis. One of the examples of expert system is robots. Today, robot surgery is very common in the world. They have been used to perform very accurate operations, such as those on the brain. Communications. Teleconferencing has been used to share expertise. This is how we enter 17 hospitals connect across India. Surgeons in one country can help those in the other. Wireless transmissions provides a link between hospitals and doctors. Telecommunications. Remote diagnosis can be used to diagnose and treat patients remotely. Patients can monitor their own conditions at home without need for a visit in a hospital. These are the latest system which the IT helps the healthcare to grow very faster. Like Modiji used to say, if it is happening in Western country, why can't we have it in India? Now India is so fast growing in ICT. ICT in support of caregivers. One is information training, website, online courses, multimedia training, ICT supported accreditation, phone helplines. Second, quality of care. Communication, coordination, collaboration, telecare, phones, email, online information. Third is working conditions, health and well-being, peer support, helplines, phone, Skype.